used to call me Bob. Today I'm called Bobby. And I chose that because I wanted some sort of feeling still about my past, because I'm not, you know, sort of hateful of my past or anything. This is my weekend club. Ever since I can remember, I think I was around 12, 13 years old. It hasn't changed much over time, but I guess it's gotten a little bit more modern in the way it looks. And I guess the cars look a little bit newer. But, you know, basically, it's still the same club it's always been. Good morning. Growing up here was just like a total home, a home away from home. Because in Hong Kong, back then, we would live in homes that weren't as big as they are in the US. Later on in our lives, as we prospered, you know, we lived in bigger homes. But this became your sort of playground away from home. My mother was born in Shanghai. Her family came from Macau. My father was from England, Newcastle. He came to Hong Kong, you know, after Hong Kong was freed from the Japanese, met my mother, and became, over time in Hong Kong, immensely successful. You know, I had a family of all boys. So the only female I knew around was my mother. My knowledge of the other sex was kind of like unknown. You know, I only knew how boys behaved. And yet I knew that I didn't feel comfortable behaving like them. And it's funny feelings that I've had ever since I can remember. Going back to about 10 years old is that I wanted to be a female. Every single night of my life, just before I would go to sleep, I would imagine myself being a female.
Just
like this. Yes, just like this. Bobby may be very rich, very high position, a lot of people know. But maybe this is a 阻力令到佢推遲咗先至可以做到佢想做嘅嘢咯。反而我哋可能冇乜人識嘅，咁就冇咁出名，唔使顧慮咁多咯。
我
幫
你擦算咗少少啫，睇唔到呢個。
我叫 Damon， 今年22歲，工作係一名研究助理，喺比較無拘無束啲嘅工作環境工作嘅。雖然我出世嗰陣被指定係一個女仔，咁但係咁多年嚟，我都係認為自己係個男仔。
我嘅阿 K， 咁今年大佢啲啦，30啦。我係男轉女嘅跨性別啦。我係做政府工嘅，咁就做執法嘅工作。
第一次見佢咧，其實我唔知佢係 trans 嚟㗎，我以為佢係一個普通女仔。咁啊，後來先知佢係 trans 嘅，咁我就覺得原來 trans 嘅女仔都有咁靚女、咁斯文咁樣，咁所以就對佢都幾留意咁樣。
大概一月，今年一月到啦，咁我工作上面有好多煩惱嘢，咁咧搞到我好唔開心嘅。咁有一晚我瞓唔著，咁佢就啱啱都仲係 WhatsApp on 緊 line。咁樣咧，所以就大家會嗰晚就開始傾偈咯。咁佢好安慰，即係喺工作上面咧好安慰我咧。咁所以我覺得呢個男仔好可以俾我依靠咯，所以我有好多好感咯對佢。
咁我小學到到中學都其實唔知道自己係一個跨性別嘅狀態嘅。咁嗰種格格不入咧，就係你會成日好莫名其妙咁唔開心啦。咁但係你揾到原因嘅。咁自從青春期開始咧，咁個身體會發育啦，咁個胸會發育啦，有月經啦。咁你開始見到同你玩開嗰班男仔咧，佢哋會一路高過你啦，大隻過你啦，把聲沉過你啦，有鬚根啦。咁呢啲嘢全部都係我最渴望擁有，但係距離我越嚟越遠嘅咁樣。咁所以由青春期開始咧，我就係莫名其妙咁樣長期抑鬱啦，好唔開心啦。咁去到有一次放學，我真係即係好唔開心到個地步咧，係我想跳咗落去就揾了結生命咁樣。
我哋只不過係做唔翻我哋原生個性別， 前好似精神分裂咁樣，咁我有機會自殺。我要做翻我自己，同埋我唔想我自己走去自殺呢條路。我唔想好似覺得同呢個世界格格不入咁，所以先去變性咯。
来到贵阳之前，我都不太爱和其他人说话，完全就把自己封闭起来的样子，因为我觉得和别人说话，别人总会欺负我。我叫 C 先生，我是跨性别男性。最早没有性别意识那会儿，可能会被家长把头发扎上啊，或者怎样怎样。但是到后来小学读书的时候，就自己会去理发店，然后自己去剪男士头啊之类。当时我一直知道我是喜欢女生的，那我就不太懂为什么我就喜欢女生，或者是不是和别人不一样。当时还是比较污名化的一个词叫同性恋，所以我就觉得哎呦，好像我不太正常或者怎样，会是喜欢一个女生就同性恋。在读书的时候，当时可能作为女生一个身体发育期，然后很多女生她会穿那个胸罩，但是我从小是不穿那个的，然后我是穿那个会有束胸之类的一些东西，然后当时那些同学就会在后面说，哎，你看到穿的是什么，好恶心，指指点点啊，或者是有一些打骂欺负之类的。就不知道十二号的活动大家有没有了解。早上我们是讲性别多元，因为现在很多世人的眼中就是说只有男和女这两种性别，让大家看到不止这两种性别。
去游泳的时候，他妈穿什么？这个是个问题。然后晚上走到街上上厕所进哪一边是个问题。
而且像我们这种跨性别，你去找工作，就算他要你了，他都会告诉你说穿高跟鞋、穿裙子什么的。但我们跨性别。怎么会去接受到这种？他说工作可以给你啊，但你就要按照我的要求来。
有的老板提出就是，我为了让别人知道我这里用异类，我这里不收异类。
所以说，为什么我们工作主要出来做这一些倡导，做这一些科普？所以我们也是为了让更多的人知道这个群体，让更多人知道，其实没有什么两样。去年四月份我去那个体检中心应聘那个销售岗位，在工作了七天之后，他们却把我当成同性恋的借口，然后还有就是穿着打扮不符合常规，就说身份证上是女的，你为什么要穿男装来上班呀之类的，然后他们就以这两个借口把我开除了。之后当时我就觉得这个心理阴影其实挺大的，比较绝望，为什么会以这两个借口来开除我。然后后来其实我也试过找其他工作，但是当我一说我是比较想以一个男性的生存方式和工作方式来进行工作的时候，所有的公司都没有给我任何回复。有的说不需要我这样的人，有的说那你等通知吧，结果就再也没有音讯。所以到现在都一直找不到工作，就因为这个身份问题，所以说工作也找不到，经济来源也成问题，一切都是问题。
Well, I think he struggled a lot with his temper. I think he was quite angry. At the time, it was very confusing. There were a lot of mixed messages. Didn't know, you know, what would set him off. You know, he wanted to sue everybody. And he was always just angry, and I didn't speak to him for a really, really long time. And he started taking female hormones, which made him definitely more compassionate, and he had a lot more empathy. He started being nicer to me. After maybe about a year of being consistently nice to me, and my sister telling me, you know, I think he's changed, you know, give him another chance. And then I think about a year after that was when he told me about this.
I'm not scared of the surgery. I'm worried about the recovery.
It's gonna be fine. This is so cool. I'm so proud of you. They were asking me about all the friends that betrayed you, and I said, well, shame on them.
All my lies were built around hiding who I was at all times. I can't imagine myself lying on my deathbed and not fulfilling it, or having a life full of regrets. So about a year or so ago, I started telling more and more and more. I told my best friend, a guy called David, and I said, David, I'd like to meet you in the Deepwater Bay Golf Club. I got something to tell you. I remember he came down there and I said, David, he said, what's your problem? You got cancer? You're gonna die or something? I said, no, I'm just gonna become a female. He looked at me and he said, you're joking. I said, no, I'm serious. Have you heard of Bruce Jenner? He said, no. I said, okay, wow, this is really gonna be difficult. So he turned around to me and he said to me, I remember it, and it was really hurtful, and perhaps the most hurtful comment from anybody, because I really cared for him as a friend. He said, I don't wanna know about it. Don't send me any information. It'd be better if you died of cancer.
我是超小米，目前是一个小店的个体户。之前我做过化妆师，之前我做过造型师，还在公关公司工作过，在一些科技互联网公司也做过一些编辑类的工作。后来想了想，我还是最爱那些漂亮的裙子呀，或者最爱那些美丽的饰品。我就是我，我站在这里，我是一个超小粒的米，可能，但是我有非常强烈的存在感，这个是我。 继续能够开心的笑着活到今天的一个理由。
在大众眼里，肯定我算小众，但是在我眼里，我不算小众。我觉得我自己就是不能算是二元性别的人。性别像是一个流动的事情，在我身上，可能有的时候男性化的比例高一些，有时候是我觉得女性化的比例会高一些，取决于我自己的心情吧。性别这个事情对我来说，我觉得不是特别重要。 或者是你在我身上可以摒除性别这个概念，你觉得我就是一个人就好，你不要管他是男是女。但就是衣服很。我第一次有契机穿上这个女装的时候，应该是在2010年左右，我印象里头。当时是有一个男孩，我非常非常的欣赏他，然后很喜欢他，然后他。
对我也是比较默认、比较许可的一个状态，就然后他给我当时提出一个要求说，你能不能把你的头发剪短？他说我不能接受，就是我的另一半是长发，你必须是短发或者寸头。这个事情给了我特别大的刺激。那个时候我就在想，你喜欢我难道就是因为我头发长头发短？然后我那个时候就毅然决然的去了商场，我并没有去剪断我的头发，我就去寻找到了一双黑色的高跟鞋，非常普通的高跟鞋，然后跟还有点粗，然后在那个高跟鞋的上边有一个像两根小表带一样的那个装饰，它就一个装饰可以在脚腕这个部位有两根小带子一样的那个缠在一起，可以调节松紧的一个小带子，我就穿这双高跟鞋就走出了商场。穿这双高跟鞋走在路上的时候遇到了一对就是建筑工地上的工人们，然后可能来自五湖四海，然后这些人就发生了非常惊诧的表情，然后哇，这个人是个男的吧
有区别的。我终于和你们只是在身份证上性别那一栏是相同的，那剩下的东西全部都是不相同的。 之后我是怎么穿上裙子之类的我都已经忘记了，我就唯独记着那双高跟鞋给我的感觉。虽然我磨的我的脚整个都是破，上的全都是血，非常非常辛苦，但是我心里非常非常的满足那一刻。现在去大柳树，一般都淘点那些小玩意儿啊什么的，然后有时候在我店里摆一摆什么的，特好玩，各种奇怪的人事儿都有呢。
走进公园，留住青春，留住美丽，留住生活和爱的全部记忆。
很多跨性别者不愿意站出来，他们认为自己这个是比较羞耻的事情，甚至认为自己是病态的，他们都不敢白天去出门，基本上都是敢晚上，就是别人都看不清自己的时候才敢出来走一走透透气。而我觉得这个对我来说已经够不成什么压力了。
太丢意思了，
小娃娃30元一个是吧？娃娃好贵啊，
是老板一点的
我可以选择非常平凡的生活，处在一个男性化的躯壳之下，过所谓的他们的新婚的生活或者有孩子的生活，但我觉得那不是真正的自我。现在处在一个裙子当中，自我这个人才是我自己。我已经有足够的信心去面对这些世界的恶意。很多美我觉得是能够超越性别的，当你不再去因为他的性征判断这个人很美很帅的时候，他的所有的魅力都是来自于他的内心。你散发出来的是良好的教养，非常高的素质，你有那种温婉的气质，能够接纳这世间所有的凶恶的时候，那我相信所有的人都会被打动。那已经上升到了人性的魅力了，已经不仅仅是外表的魅力。
I will put the primer
in
the base.
What's a primer?
Primer is like a base. It's a more, ties on with heavy look.
Okay. I never heard of that before. God, you're making it even more complicated.
I'm used to seeing somebody else in the mirror. And I think recently, you know, you get to see more and more of the female side.
I have a consultant to like go over colors, shapes.
I mean, they persuaded me to.
Cheers!
Cheers!
Yay!
Thanks, Bobby.
Thank you, girl.
I'm having two sets of surgeons.
At the same time?
Whoa. One at the top, one at the bottom.
At the same time.
At the same time.
Oh, wow. But isn't that dangerous?
No. Why would it be dangerous?
What if there's blood or something happens? Here?
Well, there's no really blood here.
Yeah, but there's a bit
of
blood down below.
Yeah, the down below. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. I really, you know, I kind of don't want to know too much about that. I mean, the amount of work they do, you know, I'm going to look different. Don't kid yourself.
You're going to steal all the boys away from me. That's like...
Don't worry, not that good a chance, you know, no matter what it is. I don't have the youth anymore. But I'll make up for it with flamboyance. My surgery is going to be quite heavy. I'm immensely healthy, so that's very lucky. But this surgery, this is a serious one, you know. Breasts definitely defines, you know, what it is. So having breasts is a wonderful aspect of it all.
How are you?
Welcome, welcome. Okay, you can sit here.
Okay.
The implant going to be the so-called teardrop or anatomical.
All right.
The real one going to be smaller.
So it comes down to the very final part of the operation that is probably the most painful and the most difficult of them all.
Here?
Yes.
For clitoris and labia minor.
Okay.
I will keep the breast supply and the nerve supply to it, so you will have the sensation at that structure.
Okay.
Is it the one-way ticket for you?
Okay, a one-way ticket. I like one-way tickets, you know?
So
it's not a cheap journey. The SRS, it costs around 8,600 US.
The breast augmentation costs around $6,000. And the facial feminization surgery costs another about $16,000 US. For a lot of people, that may not be necessary. For me, these are just extra things that I could afford and that I wanted. I'm hoping for the best and I'm prepared for the worst. But I do know this is what I want to be. I am so thrilled that I have a chance to be it. I'm about 3 days away from my surgery. I definitely feel a little bit out of place. I just keep my mind busy. I mean, you don't know what it's like. I am finally going to be who I was meant to be. I'm at peace. It is one of the most wonderful things in the world is to be reborn. How many people get to experience two lives in one lifetime that are so very different?